Pittsburgh and the steel industry have been in the news a ton lately. Everybody and their mother has an opinion on what's going to be going on in this area, but I'm going to give you my opinion too. My family's lived in this area forever. My grandparents worked in the steel mills, my parents worked in the steel mills, even I've been working in the steel industry for over a decade focusing on energy efficiency. But before doing that, did you know that Western Pennsylvania had over 100 mills operating back in its heyday?
Too much going on here right now, and that's because whenever the mills pulled out, people left because there was no more jobs, and now it's just kind of the state that it's in that you can see right now.
Hopping up on my soapbox here, with all the competition globally in the steel market, the U.S. needs to leverage its advantages on installing new technologies to make our processes safer and have higher quality steel. So that requires a collaboration between the white collar and blue collar in reskilling so that way these systems can be installed and maintained to make our competitive advantage just that much better. Just like everything else in the 70s, even working out was all about brute strength. But over the years, we've learned that there's more effective methods to get even better results. You, come here. So what you're saying is there's gonna be all these changes that have happening. I'm just gonna be automated out now. Nothing's been changing steel in 100 years.
No change in 100 years. Well, geez, it was only the 60s where EAFs really started becoming popular, and that was to meet market demand instead of just pumping out steel out of the blast furnaces and the BOFs. Next big thing coming is actually the optimization of these processes here. So that's the things like keeping them more efficient, keeping them safer, having more reliable quality coming out of them. So with that, it's a bunch of new systems that are gonna need to be installed to make those happen. And so a lot of smart people are gonna have to come out to learn how to actually install those things and actually be able to maintain them.
All right, well, show me then.
Doesn't matter if you're operating a blast furnace, a BOF, an EAF, a finishing line, or even a wire mill like we have behind us here. New innovations in technology is going to be the differentiator for American steel going into the future. Unfortunately, we have a little bit of an old electricity grid here, which is going to need replacement. Unfortunately, what that means is increased electricity costs, not only at your home, not only at your business, but also at big industrial sites like this. So the best way to combat that is to conserve as much energy as possible. So what I'm focused on here at Energy Drive is large fan and pump applications with big electrical motors and really making them as efficient as possible. And that's just a small segment of the whole entire energy universe that needs a big focus on energy conservation here. That doesn't even scratch the surface on what's going on with all these AI data centers where they're gonna be consuming a whole bunch of power. Needless to say, this ain't the 70s anymore.
Growing up in the 70s, I saw the smoke from the steel mills. Knowing that people were working, once the 80s came around, everything seemed to have stopped. My family, friends, mostly left the town. But fortunately enough, I was able to stay here in Johnstown, raise a family, and watch my son play football.
And welcome to Point Stadium.
Number big 70 out there, Jake Maruschok.
Knowing now that he's in the steel industry, the resilience I see on the football field is the resilience I hope to see in the steel industry.
Speaking of resilience, I need a lot of it right now as we're at the University of Pittsburgh's campus in front of the Cathedral of Learning here. I'm a Penn State grad, so unfortunately we didn't have enough money in the budget to travel to State College for this, but we have to make do with what we have. But in all seriousness though, resilience is really going to apply to the future workforce for the steel industry as well. So on college campuses like this, you have your traditional programs like your metallurgy, your engineering for steel applications. But now with AI being the hot topic and the need for having analytics and everything applied to everything, computer science degrees are gonna be super important in order to make the processes more efficient, more reliable, safer, and have more consistent quality. Besides the college side of things, luckily, whenever it comes to the blue collar side, a lot of the steel producers, they are investing in their own programs to send their existing workforce and even going out and finding future employees to be going to vocational schools to learn the electronic side of things, the pipe fitting side of things, welding. So all of those trades where they're never gonna go out of style and they're never gonna be able to be replaced by AI. But for the next scene, I'm gonna show you my favorite comparison for where steel was and where it's going.
We are logo. It's called the Steel Mark. It was created for the steel industry in 1960, and in 1962, the Steelers actually had that installed on their helmet as part of that season. It was so well received that in 1963, they actually changed it so that way it said Steelers on the side, and that's how they got to be where it is now.
So, yeah, this isn't the 1970 Steel Curtain defense anymore. There's a lot more speed going on now, kind of similar to how the steel industry was. In the 70s, it was ground to pound, real brute force. Today, it's a lot more agile. You have your EAF technology. You have a lot of optimization. So, I mean, what's happening on the field right now, it's new players that are brought in that are making a big difference. And that's the same thing that we need to have happening in steel.